Centrepieces will form the main design piece of your wedding reception. So you need to put a lot of thought into your centrepieces, not only making them aesthetically beautiful, but also really practical. So the way that you do that is considering two things. You want your guests to be able to talk freely to the person on the opposite side of the table. So to do that, make sure that your centrepieces are elevated or rise up above eye level. So for example, a large martini glass centerpiece. You've got the stem in the middle of the table. Generally it's transparent so that people can look through it or they can easily look around it. Then it comes up and over head level it blossoms into its full decoration up high where it doesn't obscure any eye-to-eye contact of your guests. Now if you don't want to go up, you can go down. So keep your table decorations close to the surface of the table. In that case, we'd be considering things like fish bowls with orchids in them, or perhaps clusters of tiny, small vases, all carrying different beautiful, delicate flowers. The second consideration for centerpieces is if you are thinking about using candles. Candles are beautiful, they set such a romantic scene, but they can be hazardous. Make sure your candles are always housed in containers where the sides rise up above the open flame. Because in the course of the evening, tables get messier and messier, and you've got paper elements on the table like a menu, and you've got fabric elements on the table like serviettes, and you don't want guests unthinkingly throwing them onto an open flame. The other thing is, if you're having a centerpiece that rises up high and then has parts of it that drop down, make sure that those parts that drop down don't drop into the pathway of an open flame. So that way we can make sure that your room looks absolutely gorgeous and is also safe and hazard-free.